folks, welcome back to another new episode of Linux Kernel SKB Data Structure Series, and this is part 4. In my previous part, I discussed about how the packet flows across the Linux network subsystem and the way it gets created and the way it sent across to the physical hardware device using device drivers and the other network subsystem modules as well. So, in this segment, let's discuss about how the SKB data structure is organized, and sometimes it can be used as it is, like a container, as I described in the previous video as such. And you can even create an identical copy of an SKB data structure instance. You can have multiple copies like that. It's actually designed in a way so that you can organize in a doubly linked list, and at the same time you can use it individually as I described before actually. So in the case of a doubly linked list, it can happen in a case where in which if you maintain a packet queue or something like that as such. So if you maintain a packet queue, you need to kind of organize it so that you can traverse across each node of packet in the packets in the packet queue as such. So in case if it is organized as a doubly linked list, more you can see the online pictures. If you see the SKBuf data structure, you can see sometimes Google images in this fashion where there are multiple SKB instances and each is connected back. In this way it becomes a doubly linked list, and this again connects here, and this again connects here actually. So this forms a sort of doubly linked list actually, so that from any point you can traverse across the entire list as such, which is a linked list as such. So from here you can go back here, and from here you can go back here. So you can traverse whichever direction you want from whichever position you want actually. So in the case of the real implementation, more or less you have another data structure called as SKB head, and it is somewhat like this. You have SKBuf head, which is more of a lightweight SKB. It doesn't have all the elements or all the variables which contains in a traditional SKB data structure. Instead, it is used to maintain the head of the SKB list as such. So in this case, you can have linked list variables like next, previous, and even it can have the list quantity, something like qlen equal to a number as such. In this example, we consider there are around 4 items in this queue, so it can have this queue number queue length as 4 as such. So with this, this forms the head of this linked list, and it can have multiple nodes. Each one is an SKB instance. So you have, for example, say multiple nodes, and each SKB will have a variable called next as such. Like any traditional linked list, this points to the next instance of SKB. So this again will contain next, this points here, this contains next, which points here actually. Same way, this next points here, and this next points this SKB instance actually. So this way you can now traverse in one direction. So this forms the SKB SKBuf head, and to that these SKB instances are linked actually. So same way to traverse in the backward direction as such. See, this is a more of high level representation. The way it is being implemented is somewhat like this as such. So this is continuously evolving, and at the same time in future, who knows, it may get some changes and you may not find certain variable names which is matching with respect to this video as such. So in a way to understand kind of this is how it is organized, and when you see the real implementation, you can see lot more things going around, and each time when you add a node, when you remove a node, it is advisable you use directly the APIs which is provided to do that operation actually. Never ever remove a SKB instance without an API actually, without a standard provided APIs actually, so that you don't mess around with the things. If you directly free the SKB instance, this is say SKB, and you do a K-free SKB, what happens is this instance is removed, but at the same time this will make memory to get corrupted as such. As you know, this is pointing to this memory location, and this previous is going to point this SKB instance, and you have already this previous variable which allows us to parse in reverse direction like this previous, and this will point to this head, and this next is going to point to this, and you have now a doubly linked list actually, and this previous is going to point to this node actually. Yes, there are sorry, I think I made a mistake. This next is not going to point here, instead the previous is going to point here as well. So in this way, I hope you can see that it is going to have some sort of doubly linked list fashion, so that you can traverse in either direction, and if you have multiple queues, you can have multiple escape of head instances actually, so that you can have multiple multi-dimensional linked list, doubly linked list chains actually. So this is how it is organized, but at the same time it is not strictly necessary that any kind of escape buff next and previous can be even orphan, and it can be null or something, and in that case you can have it as an individual instance where you can use it for intermediate packet processing in case it demands, because certain APIs, even the TCP/IP APIs, are needs SKB instance as well. So if you are using some sort of checksum calculation and it accepts SKB instead of the payload which you point across where exactly it resides in the SKB, instead if you want to pass the entire SKB to the API, for example in TrafficSquizzer I have so many APIs which directly processes the SKB without considering the fact that it is linked to any kind of chain actually. So in that case you have to use the SKB instead of the inside payload parameters of the network packet as well. So this is how it can be organized. It can be a kind of a doubly linked list fashion, and in this case you need to use the provided APIs which we discuss further in our video series, and in many other cases it can be even a single instance actually. So you may have a multiple network stack APIs. You have an API 1, API 2, API 3 and so on in a network stack, and suppose you are passing an SKB instance, it may not touch this or break this chain, but at the same time it may do some important operation down the lane as the packet traverses from one API to another API and goes out. Sometimes it kind of does a validation, and if it is a validation API, it may even drop this packet actually. So in that case, it needs this SKB instance actually. It cannot take packet in any other form. I mean, you can't just send the packet buffer starting from IP header or starting from Ethernet header or something like that. So, and this is how the jargon in Linux kernel. So that's very important to understand actually. So that's all folks for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like this video, please do like and please do subscribe. If you dislike, you can dislike and you can share across your comments so that I can improve. And in case if you are looking any sort of specific modules or anything related to SKB, you can shoot out your queries to me. And thanks for watching this video. Thank you.